What's up, guys? Crazy HD here, and today I'm bringing you guys Quantum Break. So we got Junction 3.
This thing growing inside me. I've been fighting it for 6 hard years. Dr. Amaral was developing a cure for the Cronon syndrome. She was the only one who could administer the treatments that kept my sickness at bay.
Paul?
And Jack had taken her away from me.
How the fuck did this happen, Morton? How is it possible he managed to take her?
Paul, is your illness talking? I'm on your side. Easy, you're...
They took her. Without Sophia, there's no chance of a cure.
We did all we could. But there are forces within Monarch working against you, and I believe Burke was just the tip of the iceberg. It wasn't just Joyce that did this.
Sir? We've recovered Dr. Amaral's laptop. We have it set up over there if you want to take a look.
I'll be right there. I want to go over Sophia's figures. If she's right, the fracture is escalating a lot faster than we anticipated.
You know the future. Dr. Amaral doesn't. Is the lifeboat even in a viable state for activation? She's trying to convince you the schedule's wrong. Why? To get you to rush this? To make a mistake? The people opposing you. She could be one of them.
She isn't.
Are you willing to bet the entire plan on that? I implore you, hold off on activation, Paul. Let me clean house before this gets completely out of hand. How do you want to proceed?
Somebody was working against me. Somebody close. Martin Hatch. Sophia Amaral. I could only trust one of them.
I want to remember him.
Immediately. So I have some information about Martin Hatch.
Martin had been my closest advisor for years. I began to wonder if that had been a mistake.
Sophia's loyal. She's always been loyal.
I don't think we can trust her. The way she looked at the countermeasure like she's seen it before. She knows what it does.
Sophia's research had saved my life. Loyalty doesn't run any deeper.
All right, Amaral. Let's go fix the time machine.
I said we'd try.
Evidence was mounting against Sophia. I couldn't simply ignore it, despite everything we had been through.
But she knew you'd never make it without those troubles. That she took them away.
If she'd turned against me with what she knew, the damage could be immeasurable.
I'm gonna go with Amaral.
Sophia's data's always been good. I'll trust her judgment. We need to analyze these figures and make final preparations to activate the lifeboat protocol at once.
Fine. I'll take the laptop to the science department.
No, I think I'll do that myself.
I see.
Sir?
Put people in Mr. Hatch. I want constant eyes on him.
Yes, sir. You got it. We pulled some images from the security cameras. We've identified Joyce's accomplice. She's Beth Wilder. One of our mid-level operatives.
Her. My God, she's been with us all along. She's working with Jack. Where is she now?
Unknown. But we've got a kill team tracking her.
No. She can't be killed. Not yet. Find her. And whatever Mr. Hatch does, I want to know about it. Don't screw this up. Beth Wilder. It was the first time I'd heard her name. But she had been there in the past. When it all started. She'd been here the whole time, working against me from the inside. And she wasn't the only one.
I only have one friend that has this game. Oh. That or that's this far in this game? Alright.
The treatments, they're losing their effectiveness.
There's no changing the inevitable. Time is just one closed loop. No matter what I do, time ends.
This is the recap.
I need to get back there.
So I'm not gonna talk for the episode.
The lifeboat protocol. What is it that you're so threatened by, Martin?
Do I look threatened to you?
This is Dr. Amaro's report. The stutters, they're increasing in frequency.
What is that?
A Kronlund disrupted life form. Extremely hostile. It's Dr. Kim.
Let's go! Let's go! Lorando! Put one of those on!
By the way, guys, before it gets further into the episode where I actually start talking, I looked it up, and the reason that the brother, Will, looks exactly like Charlie from Lost is because it is Charlie from Lost. It's Dominic Monaghan. That's what I thought, but I wasn't sure, so. But I confirmed it. You guys are probably like, yeah, we figured that out like 2 weeks ago.
What did Burke want?
Well, I don't know. I don't even know what the lifeboat protocol is.
It's a sanctuary. Designed to shelter a list of Monarch's essential personnel to weather the storm until they can find a solution.
Essential personnel? That means that I'd be on that list, right?
Not under false reason, Jordan. He's failed to see the value of his own people. Too consumed with grand ideas and delusions. You know what I find to be the most terrifying notion of this planet? The idea of God. Simply the idea. A being with that much power. The ability to take and give so freely, that cannot be true. It should be feared, not worshipped. Yet, people believe in it. Just as people believe in Paul Saloon. See, what's so scary about God isn't his control, but rather, if he ever lost it, Paul Serene has become unhinged, John. He's triggered a catastrophe. He has the chance to fix it, but he's choosing not to. He's choosing to let things end.
Name and time.
And this is where we come in. We risk too much leaving the keys to the kingdom in Omar's hands. We need insurance. There's something called the CFR. It's a crucial key to our survival and must remain safe. But as long as Paul is the only one with access to it, it isn't. With access to the CFR, I will take over. Get Monarch back on track, and once I do, restructuring will be another job. Restructuring that will see you as my right hand.
I'll be on the list.
Absolutely.
Then I need to go back to Monarch. In that sort of privileged isolation, I can only do that from inside.
I put the island on lockdown, but the pump house on the west side is an old supply tunnel that runs beneath the bay. No one knows about it. We'll go and see. Time is of the essence, John. Better get to it. Commander Davis. Head to the perimeter lab. We're moving forward.
The frequency of the stutters is still unpredictable, but they're persistent. Erratic, but persistent.
I need certainty. If I initiate the protocol, there's no going back.
Mr. Serene, something like this. There is no certainty. We've never dealt with it before.
How long?
We've been running Dr. Amaral's simulations. It's hard to say without her to confirm, but...
Just give me a time.
The Joyce Field could collapse within 8 hours. Mr. Suri, if you're going to proceed, now would be the time to decide.
Charlie. Yeah.
Hey, bud. Where you going?
You're right. Time's in there. Just like you said. And the lifeboat protocol? It's a place. They built it to protect people from the fracture. And the only problem is there's a list, and anyone who got on it is pretty much fucked. But if we make it back to the mainland, I can get us on the list.
All of this entire island is on lockdown. How are we gonna do that, Charlie?
There's a tunnel.
Hey, all right, if you are lying to me this time, I swear to God.
No, get off! Tired as shit. I don't know why you're doing this. But I don't have to put your name on shit, motherfucker.
What'd you do to him?
He's fine. I'm gonna tell you why you're gonna put me on that list. I have a pregnant wife at home. And she's the only thing that I'm thinking about right now. So if you get in the way of me protecting her, I swear to fucking God, next time, you will not catch your breath. Either way.
Thank you.
What my spirits. So, he said, here we are.
5 minutes out, Mr. Hedge. What is that? Not sure. He's playing when we came in.
Into the darkest dungeon, located in the soft depth of the dungeon.
Come to free me, my friend. This imprisonment is unsettling. It's time for me to rejoin the others, to return to the infinite.
Your wife.
3 months.
Congratulations.
You okay?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. I'm good. We need to
get on the fucking ground!
Hey,
ground!
No, we're with Monarch!
What don't you understand?
No,
get on the ground!
Hey, no. Hey, I'm the one that called it in. I'm Hatch's guy.
Wincott?
Yeah.
Where's she?
She's Chronon scientist. She's important. We have to get her back to Monarch right away. Please.
Get the fuck out of here.
Now! Yeah.
Gibson.
Fiona. Fiona. Fiona, you gotta listen. Hey.
Ah. Shit, you killed him!
Fuck! Hey! I didn't know that they were gonna kill him. What was I supposed to do? Huh? You let me on and then you kidnapped me.
This isn't about you, Charlie!
Are you stealing this car?
Just get the fuck out of here.
No, you're gonna need me.
I got what I needed out of you.
Yeah, I'm getting used to it.
Why don't you open your eyes? The world is about to end. I'm trying to do something.
Yeah, you're a real hero.
You're a douchebag.
nerves, huh? I'll see you then.
Burke.
Fuck. You know, I'm really gonna enjoy killing your wife.
Commander Davis.
Davis and his team. They're all good men. Monarch's finest.
Paul, what about my treatments?
I'm afraid so.
You know what this means.
You don't know for sure.
I'm a dead man! You let this happen! Jack, he wants me to become him. He wants me to suffer until the end.
Joyce and Brian. But what was troubling me is who got them into Kim's lab. She paid a visit while she was thought to be missing minutes before the explosion. Paul. Paul, will you listen to me? Look, it's time you see her for who she really is. This was a parting gift.
They forced her.
She's trying to destroy you.
She's trying to help me.
Oh, Jesus. Look at you. The smartest man I know. Blinded by a fool's love. Paul, what are you planning on?
Sophia's loyal.
She's gotten inside your head.
She's always been loyal.
You need to think about
this. If the fracture's happening now, I owe this to her.
Maybe having the time.
Hey, pal. I'm glad you could make it. I was just telling your girl here how concerned about you we've been.
Emily. We need to go.
Go? What's the rush?
Emily. Let's go. Emily, give me the keys. Give me the keys,
Emily. Get
away from me. Emily, listen.
No.
Listen, please. Please, please. This is not who I am. This is not. I'm telling you, I never felt good doing this. I never felt good doing this. But it's the only thing I knew how to do. And when I got back, I couldn't find anything. I couldn't find anything to do. And Monarch, they found that useful, and they put me to work. I swear to God, I couldn't stand being alone. So every Tuesdays and Wednesdays, I would walk down the street because it was the only two nights at the bartender. She wasn't at school. And I told myself every night to ask you. It took me a fucking year. Emily, if Monarch, if they gave me structure, you gave me purpose. I did this to protect you. I did this to protect us. Our family. I did this to protect our family. And Emily, you have to listen to me. Something terrible is coming. And I will explain to you on the way that we have to move. We have to move right now. If you would just let me. If you would just let me protect you. One last time.
I've just seen how much time is left.
Yeah, it's Pierce. I'm at the perimeter lab. Sir, I have some information about Martin Hatch. I want him apprehended. Immediately.
Alright, well, thank you guys so much for watching. Comment, like, subscribe, follow me on Twitter, be in the description below. As always, guys, I'm Crazy HD. Thanks for watching. Have a great day. See ya.